Welcome to our talk on what cannot be perfectly rerouted locally. My name is Klaus Förster, and this is joint work with Juho Hirvon, Ivonan Pignolet, Stefan Schmidt, and Jael Tridhan. So the topic will be routing and networks are more and more connected critical infrastructure of today's society, where we can simply not tolerate being disconnected due to some local edge failures. Let me briefly quote a recent paper for this. So the disparity in timescales between packet forwarding, which can be less than a microsecond, and control plane convergence, which can be as high as hundreds of milliseconds, means that failures often lead to unacceptably long outages. In other words, when I notice a failure, I already need to know what to do, because else, if I first need to run a distributed protocol, by the time that this protocol is finished, we might have already lost gigabytes or terabytes of data. We hence want to look at the following problem in this paper. How can we provide dependability guarantees despite multiple edge failures in the network? And to what extent is this possible without communicating between the nodes? Let's briefly formalize a model. So we look at connected undirected graphs, and when a packet arrives at a node V, we only may match on the following items. First is the destination T, where the packet should go to, then the incident edge failures, because these edges will no longer physically exist. However, these two items are not enough, because imagine that we have a node W and that the packet goes from W to V, and then V has all edges failed except the one for W. Then the packet will simply go back to W, and W will send it back to V, and so on, and we already have a forwarding loop. To avoid this, we can simply match on the incoming port, which is local information, and then if W gets the packet again, it can simply route it somewhere else, and this means that the route to the destination does not necessarily have to be a path, but can also be a walk, because nodes can be visited multiple times. Moreover, as requirements, we want that we do not change the packet in any way, and that the nodes cannot communicate with each other. This implies that the routing table should be static, and we also assume that we just want deterministic behavior in this paper. All in all, we thus want to solve the following problem. Can we install forwarding rules ahead of time to reach a destination T, such that these forwarding rules work under any set of edge failures as long as the destination is still connected to the network? And this property is something that we call perfect resilience. Of course, we're not the first one to look at this setting of fast reaction to failures. There have been hundreds of works for which we would like to refer to a recent survey. More specifically for perfect resilience, this was already investigated at POTSI some years ago, where it was shown that in general, this is impossible. However, there have also been some research on more restricted problems, namely, what if you have the promise that there will be at most one failure, then perfect resilience can be obtained. But already, if we have two failures, it's no longer possible in general, and hence we want to look at what sort of special graph classes allow or do not allow perfect resilience. Moreover, what is also known that if the graph is well connected, let's say k-connected, that you can survive k-1 arc failures. The idea here is as follows. Assume you have multiple routed trees, routed as the destination, that are also spanning. Then, when you route along these trees and have a failure, then after failure, you switch to the next tree. And if you have enough trees, well, then, for example, with k trees, you can survive k-1 failures. Let's get back to perfect resilience. And for this, let's take a closer look at the routing table at specific nodes. For example, here, the node I. The routing table tells us when a packet comes from a specific incoming port, where do we route it to, and we may change this assignment under failures, because these failures are local information. So a first thought is that all neighbors should be reachable in these routing tables, and for example, we could just install a permutation on the node I. However, is this really a necessary requirement? Here in this graph, if you want to route to T and we are at I, why should we ever route to S? All that can happen is that we get the packet simply back, and then we can also just continue routing without S. Hence, this is not a requirement, and it's not even a requirement if a node has a degree of 2. So let's continue with our local view. What can we infer at the node I that helps us with routing? More specifically, which neighbor is relevant, meaning that we actually need this neighbor to reach the destination? So let's have a close look at this graph. Since S is already rooted out, maybe for I it's V1, V2, V3. But do we really need V1? All that V1 can do is to bounce the packet back to I or to V2 and V3, and coming from I, we might already have done that. So we say that V1 is not relevant, it's just V2, V3. Now this is the situation without failures. What happens under failures? So let's add a failure between I and V2. Now V1 becomes relevant for I, because it could be that V1 is the only way to reach a destination T. Let's add some more failures. And note that I is not aware of these failures because they're not incident to I. Now the only path to reach T is the orange one, and hence I needs to eventually route to V1. Similarly, what could happen is that this failure between V3 and T moves to between V2 and T, and then V3 becomes relevant. Now this is the only path to reach a destination T, and if from I we do not route to V3, we will never reach a destination. So let's again give a high definition of relevant. From a viewpoint of a node I, a node is relevant if it might be the only neighbor to reach a destination T, since we're not aware of non-incident link failures. So what are the implications for routing? So recall that we want perfect resilience. We want to reach a destination under any cost, and if we can't reach it, well, then we don't care anyway. So I need to try all relevant neighbors. What does that even mean? So here in this setting, the packet could start at any node. For example, it could start at V3. And then if the packet comes from V3 to I, then I needs to route it to V1. For example, like this. On the other hand, if it starts at V1, it needs to be routed to V3 eventually. So for a simple solution could be like this. So what can we take away here? All of these relevant neighbors need to be part of the same forwarding permutation, else we cannot obtain perfect resilience. So now let's apply this insight to figure out if we can obtain perfect resilience on a very fundamental graph, namely the K5, which is a non-planar graph. So here I took the K5 and I took the liberty of already deleting some edges, and we just look at the situation after failures. So for the nodes 1, 2, 3, all neighbors are relevant, so their routing must actually form a permutation of all these nodes. We now assume that we start on 1, and without loss of generality, we send it to 2. And if we send it to another node, then I would just switch the failure set, but node 1 would not be aware of this. It's still neighboring 2, 3, 4. Moreover, we assume that 1, if it gets a packet from 3, then it sends it to 2 as well. Because since it's a permutation at 1, 2 needs to have a predecessor, and if it's not 3, for example 4, then we can again just adopt the failure set. Now what does this imply? If the packet starts at 1 and goes to 2, since 2 has to route in a permutation, the packet goes to 3, it goes to 1, and since 3 is a predecessor of 2 at 1, we are trapped in a loop. We can adapt a similar idea for the K33, and if you recall that for a specification of non-planar graphs, that a graph is non-planar if it has minors that are K5 or K33, and what this means I will explain in a second. Because now I want to show you that if you want to have perfect resiliency on non-planar graphs, that this is impossible. Let's start with the idea of subgraphs. If we have perfect resilience on the graph G, then we must also have perfect resilience on any subgraph of G, where the idea is that we can create such a subgraph of G by simply failing some edges, and then we can simply apply the original routing. Moreover, we still need to retain perfect resilience under contracting. So the idea would be that we again take a perfectly resilient routing function and show that we can make it work under contraction. And let me show you what I mean under contraction. So if we have an edge between U and V, and for example, the packet would take this path in orange, that then if I contract this edge and merge nodes U and V, that then the routing should still work, for example, as shown here. And we can make this work roughly with a simulation argument that we can again retain the original routing function under this contraction, but there are some details that I will skip here that are in the paper. Combined, this means that if we have perfect resilience on some graph G, then we must also have perfect resilience on any minor of G. Because in short, a graph G prime is a minor of G if it can be obtained by repeatedly using these contracting or subgraphing operations. And since there's a classic result that non-planar graphs are exactly those that have K5 or K33 or both as a minor, we obtain the following result. Since K5 and K33 do not allow for perfect resilience, every non-planar graph does not allow for perfect resilience. So as soon as you're not planar, you're out of luck. So this is now all very negative. So can we actually have perfect resilience somewhere? And we can have it, for example, on outer planar graphs. And here the idea is as follows. We take geometric routing, which is well studied in sensor networks. If a graph is outer planar, we can embed it in a plane such that all nodes are on the outer face. And then we simply apply right-hand rule to forwarding, where we just skip links if they have failed. Then this is similar to routing through a labyrinth, where you always take a right turn, which then only works if the labyrinth is just one face that you just run around. So here we even get something stronger. We even visit all nodes, and then since the destination is one of all nodes, we will eventually reach it if it's still connected to the rest of the graph. Moreover, this does not need any pre-computation. It works ad hoc, which is also why it's popular in sensor networks. You can even extend this idea a little bit. Let's look at this graph, which is the K4, which is one of the simplest graphs that is planar but not outer planar. And let's simply remove the destination. Now the remaining graph is outer planar, which means that we can traverse all nodes on this graph. And as long as at least one is connected to the destination, we will reach it. Because as soon as we have a neighbor of the destination, we can simply stop this routing and just reach the destination. So let's summarize this. So we have seen perfect resiliency is impossible already by prior work. And in this paper, we also show it's even impossible with just seven nodes on planar graphs. Moreover, we have seen that perfect resiliency is impossible on all non-planar graphs, but on the other hand, that it's possible on all outer planar graphs and also on some planar graphs, at least on those planar graphs that are outer planar if we remove the destination. So there's still some gap, namely that we need to understand what sort of planar graphs are possible and what are impossible. Moreover, I invite you to read the remainder of our paper, or maybe even the full version, where we have results on more powerful routing models, for example, that we may match on the source, also on rule space size, on exponential versus linear rule space size, and where we also discuss some further open questions. Thank you very much.